Yeah, this is from here. All right, he, the quotes on 4/10/11 to the state, 4/12, 4/12, 4/14, 4/15. Can't get that one. All right. Well, I wonder how I got stuck on the 4/2, maybe being a health plan, but that was the, is that what it said? It had roads over there.
Yeah.
That'd be within 35%.
Well, as far as the yellow highlights here?
Option one, option two.
No, is that 35% spread, Jim?
Well, that's what I'm saying.
Okay, did you exit a market or something?
Yes, suggested the base, that was 393, 402, and 404. Confident 35%.
All right, same with you, Jim, I'm sorry.
393.
402.
402.
And 404.
404.
Yep, same, no second.
404, okay. Option, oh, those yellow, aren't they?
Yeah.
Yes.
Sometimes you miss the obvious one. I appreciate you bringing up, putting me in the ditch. Okay, Jim, those three yellow at the top, those are the three I'm gonna run down, okay?
Okay.
Those three there, because those were the ones that made that 35% spread premium.
Can I have my shirt?
I don't care. Jim ain't running down, but I don't care. All right. Individual deductible, and I'm under 393, is $4,500.
Yeah.
Yep.
Again, keep in mind what the state is right beside it, underneath is 18.
Correct.
Go over to 402.
$3,000.
$3,000.
Yep.
And run all the way over to our existing plan of $6,000. Okay. Let's go through that again. Individual deductible, limited on the state is 18, $4,500 on there, 393.
Correct. $3,000 on option two.
$3,000 on option two, the 402.
Correct.
And option three, which is 404.
$4,000.
$4,000 versus our current of six. Okay. And what I'm asking you to, in your mind at this point, since we're trying to reach a conclusion or getting it narrowed down as much as we can, if you're an employee and you have those plans on the table, the state limited, Blue Cross Blue Shield, 393, Blue Cross Blue Shield, 402, Blue Cross Blue Shield, 3, and then of course we know what we currently have.
402.
So, and I don't want to ask you to choose or to publicly identify, but which one of those would make the best sense, premium wise, 481, 402, 605, 648, 71, and ours is 657. For Dr. Dodge's. Any questions? All right. Go down to the individual out-of-pocket. Now skip the family again because with the exception of one, two, but I think three maybe at the moment, but I don't know, but the one's only one. So I'm skipping the family. Go down to the individual out-of-pocket. We know the limited is $6,800, correct? Blue Cross Blue Shield, 393, is an even six, correct?
No, it's $600.
$600. Limited is $6,800. $6,800. Going over to plan option two, 402.
$5,000.
$5,000. Option three is 6,000. And current plan is?
$6,600.
All right, so again, individual out-of-pocket, limited 6,800. Option two, and again, keep in mind your premium is taking a significant jump once you get beyond the option base plan, regardless of what plans you're looking at. That's why you got lower deductible option two and option three, even though you're paying $648.71, you don't get that much of a break on your deductible, is $6,000. You're paying $657 and you're incurring $6,600 or something like this. Go down to co-insurance. Limited 70%. 50% under option base plan, $393, Blue Cross Blue Shield. Option two is at 50%, full two. Option three, 50%, and we're currently set at 70%. So, of everything that we've covered so far, even though 6,800 deductible versus 6,600 versus 6,600 versus 5 versus 6,000. That coinsurance is really a significant difference between 70 and 50%. That is going to be some major monies to be paid by the employee on the Blue Cross Blue plans that are being illustrated. Office co-pays, the state is at 35, plan 393 is at 30. Option two is at 35, and option three is 30.
50.
50. And currently we're at 35. So, you got 35, 30, 35, 50, and currently 35.
I think that's 30 on option.
Option three is 30. Yeah. 50 is for the specialist.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah. Sorry. All right, so really, those are pretty close.
Yeah.
Pretty close. Okay, on the specialist, limited is, what's that, guys?
55.
All right, under their
393
is 50. Under option two, it is 35. Under option three, it is
50.
And currently we're at
35.
So all of those, with the exception of option two, is higher for the specialty visit, $20 to $15. Prescription coverage, limited is 6,110. And then under their first 393, it is
35 and 80. Is it 60?
60. And option two is 10 and 75 and 150?
Correct.
Option three is
840
and 50, and currently we are at 10, 35, and 50. Right?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, let's take the premium one more time. Under the state's limited, you're set at 481 with a subject to premium change on January 1. Under Blue Cross Blue Shield, 393, the premium is 402.54, which would be locked in through 6:30 of next year. Whatever the premium is.
Isn't that 482?
482.
Sorry, what did I say?
482?
Yeah, I wrote that. Okay, 42.
482.54.
Yeah, 4254. And then option two is?
60581.
60581, and option three is?
64870.
And currently, we're at the 657, and we know that has been locked in. All right. What I mean, Sean, is in trying to narrow the field in this room. Anything off the table?
Well, I'm not crazy about them having to incur their deductible again until January. And we don't know what the premium's going to be until January.
Well, not, they haven't incurred the deductible if the county's picking up the HRA.
Well, they could have incurred part of it, it depends on.
Where it is, yeah. Yes, 500, technically they could have incurred, and if they had more expenses than.
They'd have the three deductibles, 500, 1,000, or 2,500.
Yes.
And then they're on.
It's still that sheet that shows it. And again, this paper's on the plan board.
So literally no one has paid $6,000.
I can't prove that. I would say that's a reasonable possibility. Well, no, they have not paid six because the max they pay is 2025.
Right. And the county picks up the cash out, right?
And we picked up.
I think there's been two, maybe three that has incurred, that has went to that because they had, I know two of us had leg injuries.
Yeah, but again, they'll care. The max would be able to.
I know, they probably paid the 2,500.
Yes,
I get that.
You're absolutely correct.
So two possibly out of 74?
No, 50 something.
56.
Yeah.
That is a downside. That is absolutely a downside.
Well, based on between the state, as far as your deductibles and your coverages, yes, what Blue Cross is offering, even if we're looking at these three and what we have now, the premiums are still less than the state. Because if you look, if you go by the Obama plan, subtracting your 129.60 from each, well, your local policy, which is 434, you're looking at 304. Now, if you max that across the board, your limited is 177, your standard is 316, and your premier is 358. Is that right, Ronnie?
Jim, I did do the subtraction.
Well,
but you just took 129 off of, right?
Right, 129 off the lower of that 434,
yeah.
Which left 304. That's your baseline.
Okay.
All right. 177.
I got 305, can I use 129?
I know what y'all were saying on the employee has to pay 129. That's
right.
That's the most we can make them pay.
Right. That's the lowest paid employee.
I get that.
Okay.
But it's just like Darryl sat right there and told you last week, you're going to cut his throat when you do that because some of these people cannot do it. If we don't pay more of that than and make them pay less than 129, I mean, it's just telling.
see, what you're looking at, your local, they won't be paying nothing. Your local insurance.
The lowest paid employee.
Right. Once you take the 129.60, that leaves 304. Obamacare says they've got to be able to afford insurance, your least hourly employee. And that's 129.60. All right, the max they can pay is 129.60.
Right.
All right, so you take that from the premium, which leaves you 304. That's your baseline. And then you carry your 304 to your other premium.
They're still paying the 129?
Yeah, they pay 129, that's all they pay.
But that's what I'm saying, they can't, some of them can't afford it.
Well, I know where you're going, Karen, but the 129 is actually, I think that's how the insurance department and the ambulance department, because everybody else is paying more than one. Okay, right now, they're sure the premium, everybody else is paying more than one. It's just that the sheriff and ambulance employee gets much higher dollar amount than they're being paid.
And that's the right.
See, everybody else is paying the minimum of the 247.
247.11.
But I know where you're going with the picture. Even though they are paying less, the benefits are less. So out of pocket, if they incur medical expenses, they're going to be paying more. It's going to cost them. And I think that's where you're going. In the total picture of things, even though the premium is less, and if they're well and good and no health and no doctor visit, I mean, it's a windfall. But if they got medical service to be provided, with higher deductibles, and maybe I should rephrase it, they have potential to pay more. If it's just an office visit for a routine cold and get a shot, whatever, then what they're incurring now deductible-wise would be, in essence, the same, because they're not meeting their deductible. Okay, the $2,025 max or the $500 max. But if they have a broke leg, and they will pay a whole lot more because their deductible has gone up to the minimum of, what, $6,000? Would that not be? Well, maybe $5,000 or whatever. Yeah. Blue Cross Blue Shield at 402 is $5,000. Individual was?
$1,800.
Well, for the state, yes, I apologize. Yes, for the individual is $1,800 with a max, including the code. Co-insurance is $6,800. So yes, they would, because here they got $500. As long as they stayed under $500, nothing changed. They got a windfall of premium. But as soon as they go above $500, it's costing them more because they're paying what they had to pay. Co-insurance will kick in, of course, which will give them the max up to the $2,025. So again, if it's coming into play, then the $2,025 would be going again. $6,800, which means they're going to pay, give or take, $4,800 more.
Where you're losing me at is that 129.
Yes.
So you've got two departments that are paying $66.
Yes.
Okay. What is everybody else paying?
Everybody else is paying $247.11. Everybody else pays the minimum of $247.11.
And how do we come up with that number?
Well, that was the plan.
Average.
No, it ain't average. That's what they're paying.
That's what they're paying.
For plan one. I don't know how it was derived.
I think the last premium increase, the employees paid 100% of that increase instead of the percentage.
Yeah, but Karen's asking how these numbers was derived. I don't know. You may have background that you can share.
Well, I have not those numbers, but previous numbers is where we. A certain premium for the $2,500 deductible. They wanted $1,000, they paid the extra money.
I understand, but just, I know these figures didn't get pulled out of air.
I don't know as if I've even seen these numbers.
But you have to.
You have to. that's what's your plan. That's your plan.
Huh?
That's your plan.
Yeah, but that's what the county adjusted those rates. I had nothing to do with those rates.
Well, I'm not sure the county versus Clyde adjusted for.
I'm sorry?
I'm not aware the county was ever involved in the decision on this rate. We just not.
Okay, because I.
Yeah, those are not mine. Those aren't my numbers.
But that's what we're paying Blue Cross to now on your plan.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Yes.
I didn't have anything to do with those.
Karen, I can't answer your question. I don't know how I got this.
Okay. All right. Sheriff's employees pay $66.36, plan one. The county portion of that is $591.60. That's what we pay.
You saying the sheriff and call, the sheriff's.
Sheriff's employees pay $66.36 for plan one. All right. The county picks up $591.60.
Right.
All right. That comes out to $657.96 total premium.
And that's what we're currently paying.
That's what we're paying now.
All employees plans and option one, that's the premium.
Now, ambulance service pays the same thing. Plan one, county picks up $632.27, which they get dental vision and life insurance. Now, where that come from there, I don't know. That's a little lopsided.
Years ago.
Well.
Yeah, it's wrong.
That was before my time.
Civil rights lawsuit, right there.
To offer everything.
You have to offer these things.
So, I mean, you know.
I wonder how many is actually paying this plan one, because I don't think that would be too many.
Okay, let's see.
Well, I can tell you, just about everybody's on plan one right now.
Yeah.
It's because they're not paying, they're only paying this, this, and this, and any of those three figures.
You just told me they was paying this. That's what I'm saying.
They are paying that.
You're telling me they're not.
Yeah, no, I'm not. I'm saying exactly the same thing. Any of those three premiums right there, $66.60 or $247, all that's cheap. That's a cheap monthly premium. $247 of that is cheap, 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 cheap. So that's the reason why everybody's on the plan one. That's cheap.
Okay.
Nobody arguing pushback against $247.11. That's cheap.
Under, all right, April invoice.
Now, those premiums right there, you're starting to, you know, where they're choosing family and all those, that's why you're not going to get that.
All right, you got 27 employees on plan one. That's as of April 12. You got one employee on plan two. You got 16 employees on plan three. Okay? I mean.
Without the highway department.
Right.
And it says, all sheriff's department and ambulance service employees are on plan one level.
Say it again, Jim.
It says here, the April invoice.
Oh, I got you, I'm sorry.
All right. Well, I'm just reading it out loud.
That's where I got.
Ambulance service, right, are on plan one, and sheriff's department ambulance employees are in plan one medical. Okay? April invoice, county general, county's portion of that, county general, county's portion was $24,474.86. Ambulance service alone, county's portion was $7,518.37. Yes, April's invoice.
Got a can of worms.
No, it's a train wreck. If you ain't got no money.
It was worse. We have five plans.
Well, you know, it's worse when you're supposed to save all this money, you come up with nothing. That's worse.
That's.
But that's neither here nor there with you.
Yeah. And the question.
And that's disgusting for me.
I would like to ask, if you pick a plan or pick some plans, can I try to show you an HMO?
We,
That was very, very successful.
Well, no.
Not the way you did the bookkeeping, but as.
No. We're getting, no. I'm not losing another $500,000.
You didn't, it went in county general, just stayed in county general, you didn't lose anything.
Sure, it was spent.
But you could open an account just for that right there, with that savings in there.
No.
Okay, and there was a man from Chattanooga that offered an HSA, and I see there's an HSA on here, the health savings account. Is there any interest in that?
It will be offered to the employee.
The health savings account will be?
Yep.
You got a network, you got a way to handle that, banks, local bank, state bank?
It will be under a company. Company will be doing that. No banks.
Who's gonna hold the savings account?
Sir?
Who will hold the savings account?
You know that gentleman's here from Chattanooga?
Yeah.
His company. But.
So you're gonna offer an HSA?
I don't think so, Jim. See, associated with the health.
No, this is totally different. We're talking about taking their federal tax money after taxes, and then they can use it and put it aside, and they can use it to either pay their deductibles or whatever.
Yeah, the first plan on the state is HSA.
Right.
It is, I knew I thought something about, it wasn't here, but here, so I said, right.
The limited is HSA?
No, the lowest one.
Oh, yes, see, yeah, I got it.
For somebody that's got a good handle on finances, that's a good deal, because they can save some tax money. It would be good for the county, because they can save tax money. I'm afraid that a high percentage of the employees will have trouble with that.
I don't think they're gonna understand it at all.
A lot of education.
What does that do?
People with families used to do an HSA.
Right, but the way it was, I mean, most of them didn't worry about it anyway, because they didn't have to pay. You know, the county's putting the bill.
All right, let me show this.
Yes, sir.
Me asking the question. Are we trying to, or is it a consensus, or are we not there, even on this point, of trying to be consistent in offering the same benefits to all employees?
Yes.
Are we trying to even achieve that?
I make a motion that we offer the same benefits to all employees.
Everybody's treated the same.
It's by law, it's a civil rights issue.
And you can't distinguish one from another. They've gotta be offered the same.
Yeah, I mean, they're offered the same plans, we just have one base, and we decide how much we're gonna pay on that base, and then.
Well, that is.
They're offered the other.
That as far as Blue Cross and Blue Shield is concerned.
Even with the state, we're gonna.